Good day, dear students. Once again, we are in the anatomy lab. Today, we are going to learn about the urinary system. In your textbook, the chapter 13, which describes about the urinary system. The urinary system is also known as excretory system. This excretory system, or urinary system, consists of two kidneys, which forms and secretes urine to ureters that brings the urine from the kidneys to the bladder, one urinary bladder which stores the urine for temporary purpose or for few hours, and the urethra that expels the urine. The function of these urinary systems are formation of urine, and also it eliminates the waste products like urea, uric acid. It also maintains the acid-base balance and water electrolyte balance. It excretes the extra waste products. It also produces the erythropoietin. This erythropoietin is a hormone that stimulates the formation of the red blood cells and the production of and secretion of the renin. That is the main important factor that controls the blood pressure. Today we are going to see the situation of the urinary system. The two kidneys, we have the right kidney and the left kidney. The right kidney is lower than the left kidney because the liver occupies the place. There are two ureters that bring the form urine from the pelvis of the urine and brings it to the urinary bladder. 600 ml of urine is stored in the urinary bladder, and then when the opportune time comes, then it is expelled from the body. This you can see in your textbook, the page number 338. You are requested to draw this diagram. And today we are going to learn about the kidney. This model of kidney you are able to see. This is a bean-shaped organ. The length is 11 cm, the breadth is 6 cm, and the width is 3 cm. It weighs 150 grams in an individual. This is the outer portion. This is a chocolate color or brown color because it is supplied by the blood. The central portion of the kidney is known as pancreas, and this is the internal portion of the kidney. The kidney is divided into two, mainly the capsule, the cortex, and the medulla. In the cortex, there are millions of nephrons. The nephron is the functional and structural unit, essential unit of the kidney, which forms the urine and tries to eliminate the waste product. Here we have the cortex, and there are millions of nephrons consist in this area. These are the pyramids, these are the minor calyces, the major calyces, and then the renal valve. From this area, the renal artery that gives the oxygenated blood to the kidneys, and the renal vein that brings out the deoxygenated blood from the kidney. Now, we will see the nephron. The nephron is the most important aspect in the excretory system. You can see in your textbook, this is the one nephron, like with millions of nephrons are consisting into our kidney. The nephron, it is the branch of the renal artery that brings the oxygenated blood, and it is the loop of capillary or network of the capillary that brings the blood. The blood is purified in terms of liquid in the kidney, and this is called efferent now. The blood is being supplied here, and then this is the through this, the waste product is being carried out, being excreted through the bowel capsule, This is the proximal convoluted tubule. This is the loop of Henle, and then the distal convoluted tubule, and then that lately the waste product is being carried out or drained into the collecting tubule. All these collecting tubules will collect their urine or their waste product, and then it will be considered as the urine, and that urine is expelled from the body. Once again, I say this is the branch of the renal artery which brings the blood. The blood is being purified in this capsule. It is known as glomerulus capsule. This is the Bowman's capsule or glomerulus capsule. This is the proximal convoluted tubule, the loop of Henle. This is the distal convoluted tubule, and then the collecting tubule or collecting duct. The blood is purified in terms of liquid in the glomerulus, in the Bowman's capsule, in the nephron. So this is a very, very, very important structure in the body. This we must learn, and this is very important for the